Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. Go home to Bel Air! In West Philadelphia, born and raised on the playground is where I spend most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool, and all shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said, "I might as well kick it. First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking orange juice out of a champagne glass. Is this what the people of Bel Air living like? This might be alright." I hear the prissy food's mine, all that. Is it the type of place that they send this cool cat? I don't think so. I see when I get there. I hope they're prepared for the Prince of Bel Air. The plane landed, and when I came out, there was a dude like a cop standing there with my name out. I was trying to get arrested, yet I just got here. I sprang with witness, like lightning disappeared. I pulled a whistleblower cabin when it came clear. The lights were blazing, fresh in it, and dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say this cab was rare, but I thought, man, forget it. Go home to Bel Air. Up to the house about 7 or 8, and I yelled to the cabin, "Go home, smell you later." Look at my kingdom, I was finally there. Sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel Air. Bel Air.